I bet you didn't know that you could remote desktop to a Windows machine from Linux. Let me show you right now. It's kind of awesome. So if you just came from my Microsoft Azure tutorial, setting up your virtual machine, your Windows 11 virtual machine in the cloud, you can access that sucker from Linux. Let's do it from Kali. I've got it right here. First thing I'll do is pull up my terminal. Now I trust that if you're using Linux, you know what I'm talking about when I say terminal. If you don't, I've got a Linux for Hackers course you'll want to check out. First thing I want to do is install RDP software for Linux. So I'll do a sudo apt update to update my repositories. And then I'll do a sudo apt install x free RDP, just like this. With this command, I'm using apt or apt and the install command to install the application x free RDP. Let's go ahead and hit enter on this. Oh, maybe it's not called that. Let's do a little magic real quick. We'll do a sudo apt find x free RDP. Oh. Maybe it's not fine. Let's try search. See, troubleshooting is fun. Well, see here, we actually found a package name right here that we can use. That's in Kali's repository. So I'll just do that. Sudo apt install lightdm-remote. I just tabbed over to give me some options. And there it is. Let's install that. Hit enter. Then we should now from our command line have the option to access the x-free RDP command. We sure do. If I type in x-free RDP-H, it should tell me how to use it. Don't worry, I'm gonna show you how to use it. So let me clear this out real quick. Ah, type in clear. The command will be x-free RDP. We'll then do a /v:, and then the target IP address of our virtual machine in the cloud. Now we didn't talk about that yet. Let me pull it up. Here in our Azure portal, looking at our virtual machine, you'll see in the virtual machine details, public IP address is right here. That's what I need. So I'm gonna grab that, paste that here, and then I'll keep moving. Then I'll do a /u:, u for a user, and type in my username, which was Bernard Hackwell for me. And then finally, password. We'll do a /p:, and then your password. I'm gonna hide mine so you can't see it. That should be everything. Let's try it out. Hit enter. You will get like a, hey, this certificate's not good. It's not trusted. It's okay. You made this machine. You should be able to trust it, I think. So hit Y on that. Just type in Y. And within a few magic moments, you should be remote accessing a Windows machine in the cloud through Linux. Look at that. How cool is that? Now, I showed you how to remote access a machine in Azure. It can be any machine that you actually have access to, as long as you have the IP address. So if you have a Windows 11 machine on maybe a Proxmox server in your lab, which if you're like, what is that, Chuck? Don't worry about it. If you have one, you know. This will also be handy as you're learning hacking. There might be a situation where you're, you know, maybe doing a hack the box thing, or maybe you're doing some real penetration testing and you need to get remote access to a machine that you actually got access to. This will do it. And yeah, right here, I'm accessing Windows inside Linux through remote desktop. Pretty stinking cool. I'll see you in the next episode.
Thanks for sticking around. To learn more about Windows and other cool stuff, go to academy.networkchuck.com. Link in the description.